Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is George, and this is SaaS Master. Today, we're going to check out Publitio. I hope I'm saying it right. If not, this is how you spell it. Well, what Publitio does is let you host images and videos. Now, you might want to say, why would I want to use Publitio if there's other free services? Well, first thing I learned in my early stages of marketing is that you can't rely on free services. You got to have a good source that you can rely on. Second of all, you want to look professional. Imagine a corporation having a site and they embed a YouTube video on their site. I mean, how cheap does that look? And third of all, you want to take a load off your hosting. Hosting plans are pretty uptight. I mean, they limit you on files, on bandwidth, and a whole bunch of other things. And Publitio is going to help you take a load off because it's going to load actually from Publitio. So it lets you host it also over there. So you can do a combination. And last but not least, you can also show videos without going through a hosting plan. So you don't even have to have a website to actually show a video professionally. All right, guys. So this is their main site. You can check it out with calm. One thing I want to say, there's a great deal going on. Check it out in the link. It's going to be in the description. Might be down there or up there. All right. So let's head over to the dashboard of Publitio. And the first thing we're going to see is that we're going to be greeted with the space used and the bandwidth used. Depending on the plan that you select is how this is going to reflect. Now, it's really important for you guys to take note that this is the main size that you will have. I mean, like overall monthly. And this is the bandwidth you can use monthly. Now, like I said, it's depending on the plan that you have. But FYI, there's a free plan also, so you can use it even in a free plan. Next thing we have, if we scroll down, it's something pretty cool that we can download SDKs. So we got Postman, PHP, WordPress, Node, jQuery, Android, iOS, Python, Laravel, and Perl. Now, I'm going to show you how WordPress works because I already installed it on the site. But first, let's keep checking out the dashboard. So the first things and the most important thing that we're going to do is, well, head over to media files. This is where we can upload new folders or upload files. We can also do it from this little green button, but I like to do it here. So the first thing we're going to do is just let's upload a file. And in this case, well, I'm going to upload myself. This is a picture of me and I'll start uploading. All right, let's wait for that to load. And you're going to see that it's pretty flexible because we can do some changes on it. We can watermark it. We can let people download it or not. We can make it public, private, and a whole bunch of stuff. All right, so this is the file that's uploaded. There's a preview. There's me. I look really good, I think. We can also copy URL, open in a new window. Let's just do that really quick. So if I open it in a new window, check this out. That's me. Yeah, that's me. I'm pretty ugly, but that's me. And what we can see also is over here. So we can edit these options over here. So what can we edit? We can edit the public ID, title. Remember the title was too long on that one. We can edit that one. Description and tags are meant for us. So for example, if we look for these later, we know how to find it. It's much easier. We can watermark it if we want. We can add a watermark. We can select files to be private or public. We can do an URL-based transformations, yes or no. Allow download via a player. So do we want to let people download what we're going to see, show them? So in this case, let's just say no. Do we want to allow ads to show in this player? So you can add your own ads over here. It's a system that you can add. And you can allow on such files, yes and no. It just depends what you want to do. In this case, no. We update it. There we go, and we can view it again. Now, for your information, my internet sucks, so that's gonna vary a lot on depending on people's things. And you can see there's no download link. If we had download active, we can do that. Now, how would a video look? So let's go to video. Open a video. Wait for that to load. And just as a quick video of my logo. All right, we got the player. See that? We can mute it. We can view it large. We can view it embed. We got options right here. See how it says descargar? That's in Spanish for download. So I have download active in this one. So for example, if I head over to edit, see how download is available. I can remove that. I can add the watermark if I want and all that good stuff. One of the things that we got is ads. So in ads is where you can add your own ad system. So you can use ads from Vast or Google IMA. So you can add those if you have those available. If you actually want to run ads on your videos, that's a pretty cool option because you can make some money off them if that's something that you want to do. Next thing is the watermarks. So you can add watermarks right here. So I've added this one, this little PNG right here. it for that to load. That's my PNG. If I wanted to add watermarks on some videos or images, I can do that really quickly and easy. Now, one of the things that I want to show you is that you can add your own custom domain. So you don't have to actually have this domain to show your pictures. So in settings, I'm going to show this really quick. You head over down here and you can use your own CNAME. CNAME, where it says custom domain. So what I did is I already have a domain, which is sasm.co. If you want to head over to that site, that's going to be available. But I created a subdomain that's called media.sasm.co. So that means when I show a video or a picture, it's going to show my domain. So that looks pretty professional and cool. So for example, let me show you that really quick. If I open this video again, I'm going to pause it really quick. Okay, pause that. See how it says right here, media.sasm.co. So instead of doing branding for another company, I can do it for myself. That's pretty awesome. Next thing I want to show you is the option to have Publitio on your WordPress. So what I did is I downloaded the WordPress plugin from the dashboard over here, and I installed my API and key, updated settings, and now I have it available to embed videos and images right from the post or page. So in this case, I'm going to try a brand new post, add a new one. This is my WordPress site. And I'm going to show you really quick what you have to do. So I'm going to use default editor in this case. I am going to add a brand new one, and you can see we have Publitio right here as an option. So let's click on that one, and you get this little square box. Let's select the file from Publitio, what we want to use. So these are the files that are already uploaded over there. Just say, hey, I want to grab this video. Click on the more options, insert source. It should be right here. Now it's on this. Let's just put test site, and I'm gonna remove the sidebar so it looks bigger, no sidebar. And well, let's preview this, see how that looks. Like I said, the speed of all this loading is my internet that really sucks, and I'm sorry. In this case, I'm gonna show you what happens. So what happened is that my hosting plan loaded everything except for the video. I didn't have to take up space from my hosting plan or resources to play this video from my hosting plan. So we might have a pretty sucky hosting plan, but since we're using Publitio, this won't affect it. So this is actually played from Publitio and not from the hosting plan. And see how easy that was? And imagine uploading like, a 500 megabyte video that takes up like 15-20 minutes. Imagine how much resource that takes on your hosting plan, and you can take that load off and actually look more professional. So instead of loading everything on your hosting and making your site slow, this will make it faster. Well, you can do this with images and with videos. Also, you can resize images from the link, and I'll set those in the description so you see how that works, because I still need to check how that works. And we also have download available here, embed in player codes. So if you want to embed this in anywhere you want, I mean, as long as you have like HTML square that's available, you have the source, iframe, and player. You can also select from here, player options. Oh, I had to show you that also, the players. Skip that. So let's click on players right here. And what players do is give you like a kind of a customized look. So for example, on this one I'm using, or one I'm going to create, for example, mine, does it SAS Master 2. So in my case, my logo is green. So let's keep that green branding going on. We choose green, and the player will actually look, the player is going to look green, the little play button is going to look green. Do we want to autoplay when I choose this type of player? Well, mouse hover over, that's pretty cool. Control bar on, what is this for? Let's just say, for example, you want someone to actually view the whole video and not just jump around. Well, you disable this and they can't jump in the video. Thumbnail on seek on, default quality. You can upload more quality, so 720, 1080p. It just depends what you want to use. Do you want it muted by default or on? Add tag ID, and you can do that right there. Oh, I already have main two greater than. Just say SAS. Create. Well, I don't want to actually create that. I already have my player. But did you see how easy that was? And this will give you a better and more flexible look for your videos and images than other places. Well, I hope you guys like Publitio. If you guys want to grab the deal that's going on, the link is going to be in the description. Thank you for watching. My name is George, and this is SaaS Master. See you later.